YouTube Stories expire after 7 days. YouTube Shorts remain forever. YouTube Stories is not searchable. YouTube Shorts is searchable. YouTube Stories don't appear on viewers' computers. YouTube Shorts appears with regular videos. How am I going to decide what videos to make? In this video, you'll discover the pros and cons of YouTube Stories versus YouTube Shorts, so you can decide for yourself what kind of vertical video you should create. Here's how YouTube Shorts works if you have the feature on your phone. Tap the plus sign, tap create a short. You also have the option to upload a video from your camera roll or go live. In this case, we'll just tap on the button create a short. Start recording your 15 second video. Hit the button again to stop recording. Add some music to your video. Tap done when you're finished. Here's how to create a story from the YouTube app on your phone. Tap the YouTube app, tap the plus icon, tap story. I can record myself by just tapping the button, or I can select a video from my camera roll. In this case, I already recorded a video, so I'm just going to select a video from my camera roll. Tap the icon, tap on the video. On the right here, I've got filters, text, I can draw something, add stickers, adjust the volume, and trim. For instance, if I add stickers, then I can select videos like recent or uploads. I can add emojis, etc. After finishing, just tap next, and then I can post my story. Hey, if you're finding value from the content so far, hit the subscribe button and click the bell notification icon so you'll be notified of new content like this every week. You can watch a story on the YouTube mobile app, either from your subscriptions feed, from your homepage, or on some watch pages. When a creator has shared a story, you'll see a colorful ring around their profile picture. Just tap the profile picture to watch the video. If you want to skip to the previous or next video in the story, just tap to the right or the left of the video player. If you want to pause the video, just hold down on the screen. If you want to subscribe to a channel while watching a creator's story, just hit the subscribe button within the video. You can also dismiss the video by just tapping the X. If you want to make a comment, just tap the comment entry box. You'll be able to view other comments as well. If you want to learn more about YouTube Stories, click the link in the description to watch my YouTube Stories tutorial. You can find Shorts videos by browsing the Shorts shelf on the YouTube homepage from the YouTube app. It's currently in beta, so not everybody has this feature. It's currently being rolled out to India, but it'll be rolled out to others in the coming weeks. YouTube Shorts also appears amongst your regular videos, so when you publish a Shorts video, it can be searchable on YouTube Search. You can also find Shorts by selecting the What to Watch Next module. This appears to viewers that have subscribed to your channel. Keep in mind this section is dynamic because YouTube shows content that subscribers have not seen. For example, if a viewer has recently watched a video from your channel, then YouTube will show a recent upload from your channel. You can also find Shorts videos by checking your subscriptions feeds. If you want a better chance of your video appearing on the Shorts shelf on the YouTube app, then YouTube recommends adding a Shorts hashtag in the title. This is mostly recommended if using the Shorts camera, but recently I found out that you don't necessarily have to add the hashtag when using the Shorts camera. If you're uploading a Shorts video from somewhere else, such as a desktop, then include the hashtag Shorts in the title or the description. Since Shorts videos appear with regular videos, you can comment and subscribe to the video from the YouTube app or from your computer. If you want to learn more about YouTube Shorts, click the link in the description to watch my YouTube Shorts tutorial. Stories have a length of 15 seconds, and Shorts videos also have a length of 15 seconds if you're using the feature on the YouTube app. If you're not creating Shorts videos using the Shorts feature on the YouTube app, then you can create videos that are less than 60 seconds. You can create a vertical 60-second video by uploading it from your computer or from the YouTube app, even if you don't have the Shorts feature on the app. Comments on stories will expire with the story after 7 days. However, you can still view the comments in your YouTube studio for 30 days. Comments on Shorts currently last forever because they're uploaded to the same place as your regular videos. Since Shorts videos appear with regular videos, you can comment and subscribe to the video from the YouTube app or from your computer. YouTube Stories currently requires 10,000 subscribers, but these requirements may come down in the future. The beauty about YouTube Shorts is that there's no minimum requirements, so you can get started right away even if you have zero subscribers. Some creators, like MrBeast for instance, have made a dedicated channel just for YouTube Shorts. Let me ask you a question. Are you currently creating YouTube Shorts or YouTube Stories on your YouTube channel? Post your answer in the comments below. I'd love to read them, and I'm sure others would too. If you open up the YouTube app, you'll see the total number of views and subscribers you received in the last 14 days from your stories. For YouTube stories, you can check the number of views, likes, and comments you got on your stories at the bottom of the video player. If you click on more at the bottom of the video player, you'll be able to delete the story. Keep in mind that public viewers won't be able to see the comments, likes, and views on your own story. To track the performance of a YouTube Shorts, you can just look on YouTube Studio under Analytics. I've discovered that the main traffic source for YouTube Shorts is under Direct or Unknown. Here's an update from YouTube where you'll be able to view traffic sources for YouTube Shorts.
So in the next couple of weeks within YouTube Analytics, you'll be able to see the views coming from Shorts under Traffic Source Types. That's under the Reach tab. Now, it's really important to note that those views seen from the home page are going to come up under Browse Home, and all other views from Shorts are going to come under Shorts Traffic.
Shorts appeal to mobile users because you can easily create a Shorts video on your mobile phone. You'll also be able to see Shorts videos from other channels on the Shorts shelf on your YouTube mobile app. These vertical 15-second to 60-second videos should be standalone content. When you create a title for your Shorts video, make sure it's searchable so it can be found in the YouTube search engine. You can create a teaser video for your main video. Just tell people to click the link in the description to your main video. You could share a series of tips. You can make an entertaining video. You can answer questions that viewers have asked in your comments. Stories are great for sharing tips, asking questions, and showing what's going on behind the scenes. So Herman, what's your recommendation? Shorts videos are great because you can create them quickly and they appear on the Shorts shelf on the YouTube app, and you can also add them to your channel homepage. They're searchable, which means if you have an optimized title, they'll appear in the YouTube search results. Plus, you can get great analytics from the YouTube Studio. If you have access to the Shorts camera, you can use the editing tools to do things like string multiple video clips together, use speed controls and timers, and add music to your video clips. The cons are that the Shorts feature on the YouTube app hasn't been rolled out to other countries besides India yet. Also, there's no way to currently monetize YouTube Shorts videos. Shorts videos may also affect the audience retention of your long-form videos. The pros for YouTube Stories is that they're easy to create. You just take out your phone and start shooting the video. It's a great way to interact with your community. The cons are you currently need 10,000 subscribers, and you also can't monetize these videos. Do you want to learn more about YouTube Shorts or YouTube Stories? If that's a yes, watch this video tutorial on YouTube Shorts and watch this video tutorial on YouTube Stories. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.